the other groups that we find in our high species diversity mixes are going to be our grasses. So here we might see our sorghums, our forage sorghums, our sedan grass, our sorghum sedan. And so all of these can get very confusing as we're starting to differentiate our just sorghums from some of our other grasses. One of the things that we can look for is on the stalk, you'll find this white powder on our different sorghum species. When we start to think about some of our plants as being more drought tolerant, a lot of our more drought tolerant crops tend to have a silvery tinge to them. And so this glaucous appearance, just like glaucoma in the eye, this white powder that's on the stalk is helping really reflect some of that radiation that's coming through our sunlight to help cool down these plants just a little bit. So if we compare our corn to a sorghum and start to think about some of that heat tolerance, we can start to think of some of the attributes that are on our stalks of having that white glaucous powder there. So those are our sorghums. Now, our other grasses that we might find within our high species mixes are our millets. And there can be a lot of different millets. This mix specifically, I think, had about 5+ different millets, and there's only 3 that are really present, once again, because of some of the temperature differences that we find. And so a few of our common millets, we have foxtail millet. And foxtail millet is found in a lot of our different cover crop mixes. It's used quite a bit throughout production areas as a bird seed additive. And so we'll see it as either crop or cover crop. For our foxtail millet, it has this bristly appearance, and these can get fairly large. This one is not yet mature, which is why it still has the green color. And as we start to pull these back, there's little seed clusters. And so each of these, this is a panicle. And so each one of these little clusters is like its own little branching panicle cluster. And so this is our foxtail millet. Now, some of our other millets that are in here, this is Japanese millet. This is actually related to barnyard grass. So it's going to look very similar and kind of has these spur type appendages. When we look at the scientific name for barnyard grass, it's Echinocloa cruscalli, and that actually means cockspur. And so you can kind of see that idea behind these spurs on this seed head. This is also a panicle like all of our millets are, but it's much more open compared to our foxtail millet. We also don't have all of the long awns on this compared to maybe some of our barnyard grasses that will have very long awns on top of these panicle appendages. And then our last millet that's in this mix is brown top millet. And brown top millet would probably be confused with proso millet in some situations, but proso millet has a much more drooping appearance to the seed head, whereas brown top millet is coming straight up and erect, more so like a sorghum. And whenever we're looking at the stem on our proso millet, it's going to have very distinct hair ridges going down the stem, and it's nearly going to look like it's a pinstripe on the stem itself. We still have some of that pinstriping on this brown top millet, but it's not as distinct as what we find on our proso millet.